How to learn a language in just 30 days, the ultimate step-by-step you need. Learning a language can be a rewarding and enriching experience. Besides keeping you intellectually and psychologically sharp, it also offers you a window into a new culture and gives you a fresh perspective on life. Don't wait several months or years trying to learn or relearn a language the wrong way. A few tips can help you do the trick in less than a month. Welcome back, folks, to another edition of Sweetie Kiwi. I hope you are doing fantastic. I'm doing marvelous. And if you are doing as marvelous as I am, go grab a cup of coffee. Today I want to talk about how to learn a language. And of course, you know, after a month, you wouldn't be maybe fluent, but not, you know, as fluent as a native speaker. But that's all you need, right? You want to be fluent. So, I want to quickly give a shout out to Holly, Francis, Robin Hammond, and Lee, Francis, and Justin Beckman, for Lifey. Francis, thank you to all our millions of viewers for their support. We really appreciate it. Now, number one, you want to focus on fluency, not accuracy. This is very important. If you want to increase your, if you want to speed up the learning process, you want to focus on fluency. What is fluency? Fluency is the ability to express yourself easily and articulately. Right? It means you're using the language smoothly in real time. That's all it is. Now, accuracy, on the other hand, is the ability to be correct, precise, right? It means that you are communicating without any error of grammar, vocabulary, or you don't have any tonal, any other errors, right? Now, this is very important. Nobody really cares about accuracy as long as you are fluent. If your job is, if your goal is to learn a language ASAP within 30 days or 2 months, you want to focus on, you know, speaking your mind the right way. So if, for instance, you have to start thinking about certain phrases, you know, like, you know, good morning, how are you today? I want to take the train to the city, you know, or where is the nearest train station? Those sort of basic everyday topics. You want to have a few sentences that you memorize and that you're able to carry a conversation. So once you do this, once you start with a few sentences that are repetitive, you want to have at least 5 minutes of conversation without interruption. Once you are comfortable with 5 minutes, move on to 10 minutes and then 15 minutes and then 20 minutes. Now, the trick here is you don't even need to have someone to talk to. You can talk to yourself. You can basically set up a topic. For instance, you know, you set up a scenario. You know, for instance, you are at the train station and you want to ask a police officer where the nearest train station is, or where the, like, just have a whole scenario and tell yourself, I'm going to ask 5 questions. How do I ask those questions? And you can write them down and keep rehearsing. The idea here is that accuracy is not important. Nobody cares at a train station whether you have a proper grammar, right? Nobody cares at midnight when you're trying to get home, you're trying to hail a cab. That cab driver wouldn't care about your vocabulary or your tonal errors. Nobody cares about that. They care about fluency. Can you convey your idea in a clear and concise way? So work on that. Again, start with the everyday sentences that you have to memorize. And you want to say this, you want to test yourself whether or not you can carry a conversation within 5 minutes, okay? And then you move to 10 minutes. All right, number two, live with locals who don't speak your language. This is very important. If you force yourself out of your comfort zone, you will learn fast. If you want to learn within 30 days or less, you want to immerse yourself in the culture of, in the foreign culture you want to, you know, which, whose language you want to learn. And most importantly, you want to live with locals. It's wonderful if you surround yourself with senior citizens. If you live, for instance, you live with a grandfather or a grandmother who doesn't speak English, you're going to be forced to learn, right? Another trick that also works is if you surround yourself with children. In other words, you go to, like, if you talk to children, they usually speak slowly, because a lot of the problems of foreigners when they're trying to learn a language is that the speed of conversations is too high. So people speak so fast that, you know, if you are not a native speaker, it's hard for you to understand the word because not everybody articulates. So, but if you speak to a senior citizen or a child, they will take the time. They tend to speak slower. They tend to speak more slowly, and you're able to understand what they're talking to, right? So this is very important. You have to also speak, when you speak to people, make sure they're speaking back to you. And it's very important to pay attention to how they respond to you, the words they use. It doesn't matter, don't try to remember all the sentences. Remember a few of them. You can say, you know, today I'm going to remember 5 sentences that they used while replying to me. All right? And this is very important. If you want to learn fast, you cannot rely on an app or rely on a book, trying to memorize a dictionary. No, you have to speak. All right? I'll be right back right after this. Do not go anywhere. Welcome back, folks, to another edition of Sweetie Kiwi, and I'm just very happy to have you here. If you love the quality of the content that we are sharing with you today, and we release new shows every day, rain or shine, please consider subscribing to our channel, turn on the notification bell so you are aware when we release a new show, share this content, like it, comment below, let us know if you have other tricks and tips to learn a language faster. We are about sharing the intellectual wealth so everybody knows what's really happening. I want to give a quick shout out to Carly LeBlanc and Buddy Silverberg, that's in Montana, Frankie Bender in Great Falls, Montana, and Willie Hume in Hamilton, Montana. Thank you so much, Carly, Frankie, and Willie. We really appreciate it. Now, the third thing you need to do when it comes to learning a language in just 30 days or less, understand why you want to learn the language and find the motivation to get it done. It's very important. I've seen in my personal experience that if you get the motivation right, if you can understand why, the main reason why you want to learn a language, it goes faster. You know, for instance, I've seen people who actually, you know, married, I have friends, personal friends who marry foreigners, and all of them were men, and they wanted to give a speech in a foreign language at their wedding. And I've seen them make progress like crazy. They were able to learn languages very fast because they knew 100 people or 200 people would listen to them speaking in their foreign language. So they really learn fast. So if you have a motivation because your loved one is foreigner, that's a great motivation, right? Or let's say you get a job offer in a foreign country, and that particular job will entail speaking with the locals. So you can't use English. You are forced to learn. So you gotta get the understanding that the reason why you want to learn the language is very, very important. If learning a foreign language is just one of your pet projects, and it's one of those things, if you do it, it's fine. If you don't do it, it's fine. Then your mind doesn't see the emergency. Your mind doesn't see the urgency, right, of making the move that will enable you to make progress fast, right? So once you find the reason why you want to learn the language, you need to find the motivation to do it. The motivation usually is linked to the reason. If you get the right reason, you should have the motivation. Like I said earlier, I was giving you the example of my friend, one of my friends who got married to a Chinese, and he was able to learn Mandarin in less than 90 days. Again, not learning like as a native speaker, but he could hold a conversation for 2 hours in Mandarin. And that was brilliant. That was amazing because, you know, going from, you know, only an English speaker to speaking Mandarin, and now he's learning Korean, right? So it's the motivation. And the reason why he's learning Korean is because he found a job in South Korea, and that job will start next year, and he needs to be fluent because not every Korean, you know, not all of the customers he will be talking to speaks English. So the motivation is critical. Number 4, you want to watch the locals talk. This is very important. This is part of the immersion that I was talking about earlier. If you're not lucky enough to live with the local, whether, you know, a senior citizen or somebody or a friend or whatever, at least watch them talk. Nowadays, fortunately, we have a lot of resources. You have gazillion resources that allow you to watch local stuff. You can watch videos on YouTube for free. You can watch movies, on TV or Netflix in the original version. So you want to have subtitles so you're able to watch the locals talk, right? Because the thing is that, you know, different languages make different demands on your tongue, lips, and throat, right? Because the thing here is that pronunciation is as mental as physical, as it is physical, right? So you want to really sort of get in the habit of using your lips, your tongue, and your throat differently. So the thing here is that you want to start watching a native speaker and imitate them. If you're lucky enough to have a friend who is a native speaker, that's even better, right? So you don't have to do you don't have to go on YouTube or watching foreign language movies and documentaries and TV, right? Another thing you can do also is listen to children's program as they teach kids the native language, the specific language you're trying to learn. So go back to basics. So you can go you go on YouTube, or you can, again, trying to stay away from books, because here we're talking about speaking the language in less than 30 days and being fluent rather in less than 30 days. So you have to speak. I'm not here to tell you to read a book about, no. You want to watch a video, to go back to an educational video, right, about the language and about teaching kids. If the video is about teaching kids about the alphabet, the basic sentences, everyday sentences, this could also help you. All right, so you need to learn by listening to people before you can speak. All right, and again, everybody thinks, a language is complicated. Like my friend, as I was telling you, he thought that Mandarin was just very complicated at first, but today, again, after 90 days, he's very fluent, he is comfortable. So every language may sound strange the first time you hear it, but the more you expose yourself to it, the more familiar it becomes and the easier it becomes to speak it properly. All right, I'll be right back right after this. Do not go anywhere. Welcome back, folks, to another edition of Sweet Kiwi. We're still talking about how to learn a language in just 30 days. Today's show is the ultimate step-by-step you need. I want to quickly give a shout out to Tatum Riddle in Sunderstone, Rhode Island, Noel Sutton in Providence, Rhode Island, and Amir Tucker in Newport, Rhode Island. Next thing you want to do is you want to find a language partner, right? Don't worry about, don't be shameful. I mean, there's no shame in asking someone else for help, right? So you can ask someone to be your language partner. Usually it works if the person also is learning something from you. So let's say you want to teach someone English and they're teaching you Italian, for instance, right? You can find language partners. There exist several platforms on the internet that will connect you with people in the target country. You can even use social media. There are groups on Facebook, for instance, that allow people to connect and find exchange resources. So it's very important to speak. So the idea here is to speak. So if you can't speak with if you don't have a friend who is native, consider having a language partner. All right, again, like I said, it's a lot easier if it's a win-win. All right, because no matter what stage you are at in learning your new language, find someone who also trying to learn the language. So you can do it either way. You can find a native speaker, or you can find someone else who is trying to learn the language, right? So what you do is you can schedule times to meet up and share any progress and offer feedback for one another, right? So exchange resources or tips that have been helpful to you. So that way you both are growing together. And this could also be part of a club, right? This could be a language club. You can find language partners in language club, similar to book clubs, right? So you meet periodically once a week or twice a week. I mean, twice a week, that would be too much, but twice a month, where you share ideas and perspectives and other stuff, right? So number six, next thing you want to do is you want to correct every mistake and celebrate it. Now, it is important to understand that as you're learning a new language, as you're learning a language, be humble. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to be bad when it comes to grammar or vocabulary. My English is not really that good. So you want to start paying attention to the mistakes that you're making. And the more mistakes you make, the better you start. You need to start paying attention, because some mistakes at the beginning will come back and back and over and over and over. What you want to do is you want to start taking notes, right? The words and phrase that you would have, that you are making mistakes while using, you know, the new words that you just heard in a conversation or that you saw, write them down. And again, use them in a sentence. Just writing down that the word itself wouldn't make any difference. But if you use it in a sentence, you are gradually increasing your vocabulary, right? So this is very important. Now, what I'm trying to say here is that humility will help you. And trying to have this sort of humble and grateful approach, because you could be the smartest man or woman in the world, right? But if you don't become humble, you are shielding yourself from endless opportunities for growth, especially as you engage, as you embark yourself into a new culture, all right? And this is basically very, very important. So number 5, find a language partner. Number 6, correct every error and celebrate it. I will be right back right after this. Do not go anywhere. Welcome back, folks, to another edition of Sweetie Q. We're still having a conversation about how to learn a language in just 30 days, the ultimate step-by-step you need. Now, for those who wants to know like the context of today's conversation, it's very simple. Learning a language can be a rewarding and enriching experience. Besides keeping you intellectually and psychologically sharp, it also offers you a window into a new culture and gives you a fresh perspective on life. Don't waste several months or years trying to learn or relearn a language the wrong way. A few tips that I'm giving you today can help you do the trick in a month or less. Okay, so one of the tips that really matters to me personally is to have fun in the process. It's very important. If you're not having fun, you're not learning. You know, try to reward yourself. Reward specific milestones. Be happy. Eat some chocolate. Act like a child. It's very important. Leave your comfort zone. Be willing to make mistakes, right? You know, be willing to put yourself in potentially embarrassing situations. Who cares? This might be scary, but you know what? It's the only way to develop and improve, right? The thing here is that if you don't, you know, you got to talk to strangers in the language, ask for directions. You got to try to tell a joke, order some food, be on the phone, talk to a bartender. You got to put yourself out there, you know, and you know, the more you leave your comfort zone, the better you become, because gradually you are creating a new comfort zone in the language you're trying to learn, right? So you know, practice. You know, if you remember, when we were kids, we didn't care about mistakes, right? We were just learning by making mistakes. We were going through trials and errors. You know, we were like goofy. We didn't care. Now, as adults, we're just so into ourselves and so, like, you know, so into the whole reality. We have to be correct. The whole attitude that mistakes have become taboo, right? So basically, this is really weird. I mean, you know, if you think about it, people will tell you right away, oh, you know, I can't speak Japanese, or I can't speak Arabic, without even giving a try. They're just saying already, you know, I can't do this. You know, I can't drive, I can't swim, I can't sing, I can't tell a joke. You know, that kind of stuff. So, you know, we are blocking ourselves already the potential pathway to creativity. So you need to have fun. You know, act like a child. You know, it's okay to be goofy at times. Try to find fun ways to practice your language, your new language, right? All right, you can write a poem, you can simply talk to whomever you can. Try to find ways to make the whole process interesting. All right? So this is basically what I had to tell you today, and if you do those things, you can learn a language in just 30 days or less. Again, learning here means you are fluent. You are sleeping, you're thinking in the language, you are talking to yourself, you are engaging all the things that I've said here. And here are the seven things that will help you. You want to focus on fluency, not accuracy. Live with locals who don't speak your language. Understand why you want to learn the language and find the motivation to do it. This is critical. What is the why? Watch the locals talk. Find a language partner. Correct every error and celebrate it. Have fun in the process. All right, I hope you had fun listening to me today. And until next time, stay more of a loss.